me and Dom, we met quite a few years ago now. It was through the festival circuit. I got invited to do a Q&A in Leeds to present all my short films that I've been putting on YouTube. And when I came off the stage, it was really fun because, you know, Dominic's famous for being Paddy on Emmerdale. And that's how I know him. So when I came off the stage and Paddy from Emmerdale comes and shakes my hand and congratulates me and asks me, like, who I am, what I'm doing, and tells me that he loves my stuff, I'm like, dude, I know you from the TV. So, you know, I had a lot of time for him instantly and just kind of, like, starstruck as well, as weird as that sounds. And he was very keen to get involved in any of my productions, so he actually does, like, a big part in a 20-minute film that I made called Ghost Burger. And then after that, he asked me to do some claymation for him, and then this was just another project that he asked me to be involved with. He just seems really keen to have me involved as a fanboy. He's like one of my biggest fans in a way that friends can. And to be involved with this for, like, a director, just because the portion of the film where he's asked me to do the animation as well is, like, the final act, you know. It's a real exciting part of the film, so for it to just suddenly turn into claymation is absolutely bonkers, and for him to let me do that as well is just, like, let me have at it. And I've had a great time, like, doing the sequence for his film as well. I've got really mixed feelings about it. I don't know. I guess they're not as quite clear as you might expect them to be. And the reason I use clay animation is purely for budget and getting productions made. And that's how it started out in the first place. But what it ended up becoming was just aesthetically pleasing to watch, and just seem to go hand in hand with the genre of horror so very well, and violence as well, like violent cinema. It just seems to work very well and seems to achieve emotions that haven't really been achieved in live action before. So I guess it gives me that exploration of doing those kind of films and that kind of stuff. There's always one that always sticks out with me. It's really funny. I've got this friend called Ted Gagan who always, every time I see him, he lives in America, every time I see him, like, doing the circuits, he always brings up this one film, and I have to agree with him because it's the one that just turned out so, in a way that if 8-year-old me just watched that, I'd have been like, wow. It just contains, like, so many elements that I would wish to see in a film, and I managed to do it to my own satisfaction. It's a film called Nightmare by Love Automatic, a music video actually. I made it in 2011, and I don't know, it's a film that I would like to explore and produce into a feature film if I ever had the opportunity at any point.
I really hope you do get that opportunity. I mean, is feature something that you are ambitiously pursuing in terms of a full-length claymation?
Oh yeah, but yeah, I am. It's going to be a long journey. It's not as simple as just waking up tomorrow morning and saying, hey, I'm going to make a feature film, even though it can be, but it depends what kind of risks and depends what kind of roads you want to take to that goal, I suppose. And I'm trying to be careful and trying to take my time. And yeah, I don't want to rush into these things. I want to crack on and do a feature film at some point, but I want to do it right.